your girl Risa coming to you today. I'm getting ready to revamp this picture for Biscuit 20 G's. I want to say welcome everybody. I hope y'all in good spirits today. Let me straighten y'all up just a little bit. Okay, hopefully y'all won't fall. Okay, so y'all can get a look as to what this picture looked like. So her room color has changed and she asked me to do a little something with it. So I have some paints that I'm gonna work with. I don't have a vision in my head yet, but as I go, y'all will see it unfold. So I have house paint that I've used on the outside of my house, in the house. We have some, and it's called a deep wine. That's this color. So she wants some splashes of that. I have several grays. So I have this dark gray. It kind of almost looked brown. And I'm going to mix some of this with white. And this is a white flat, but I'm not going to use the flat. I have a satin because this gray one is satin. And so I have this satin white that I'm going to mix with that gray to get the color that I want. Okay. So I have a few little paints that I got from Walmart. There's a Wild Iris. It's a purple shade. I have a little Mod Podge to add some glitter. An elephant gray. This is kind of sort of the gray that she wants, but I doubt it if I have enough to cover the entire thing, but we're going to work it out. I have some brushed metal acrylics, and this one is brushed gold. This one is a acrylic high, what is it? A matte finish. Excuse me. This one is a antique gold, and it's a matte finish. Always need a little black somewhere in your picture. At least I do. This one is a King's Gold. It's a matte acrylic, quick drying, easy cleanup paint, and it's more of a yellowish tone. This is a bright magenta. And then I have some gold spray paint by Rust-Oleum that I had from another project. So we're going to go ahead and get started. I've already opened my paints, so we're going to slide them over here until I'm ready to use them. What I'm actually going to do is turn around and go to the other side in just a few minutes after I mix this paint together. So I got a little bucket here that I'm going to use. Okay. So we got that. That should be enough to cover it. It might be too much, but hey, we can always save it. And I'm messing up this tablecloth. It's all right. Okay. Let me move this one since it's not open. We're going to sit this over here so it won't keep draining. So let's mix a little bit of this gray. With that. And I think I'm going to add just a little drop of black to see if it might help out just a little bit. Okay. So, I have some little paint brushes here. These are Jalen's. She got for Christmas. And I have some orange shades in here. And some, what are these? Some other art acrylics. So I'm gonna just go ahead and mix it with this brush and see what we get. It's just about almost the shade edges to it, because that kind of look muddy and I don't want it to look muddy, and that has a lot of blue in it. So hopefully mixing these together gonna work just a little bit. Janae, you want to come tell me if this is the color you want?
Yeah,
that's good. Yeah. Okay. All right, y'all. We're going to get started.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, this is the finished look of the painting that I did for Janae's room. I will attach a before picture and an after so you guys get a chance to see it. She asked for some glitter, so we gave her some glitter. She asked for a little more burgundy, and as you can see, I put my name at the bottom. Yes, it's a one-of-a-kind piece. I don't know if I can recreate it. I just had to feel it, y'all. I hope you guys like it. Janae, I hope you like it.
Yes, I do.
Okay, from 1 to 10, what you give it?
A 10.
A 10, all right. Don't just say that because I'm right here.
No, I'm not just saying that. You know if I ain't like, I would tell you.
All right, so this is it, y'all. Thank y'all for watching.